Okay. Oh no. Hey guys, I'm Joe. I once heard about this world record that a guy broke where he walked 20 miles with a book balanced on his head. I'm determined to break that record by next week. And it feels like it's super easy. 20 miles, piece of cake. It's the book on the head part I can't get right. I think I'm lacking a crucial element here, but I'm not sure what it is. It's not a hat. What about a string? No, it's not a string. It's probably something more elusive. Grace, that's right. You know anyone who's ever been graceful to you? What is grace? It's like someone who finished that cartwheel without falling over, or someone who can juggle balls without dropping them on the ground. Or like maybe someone who could walk 20 miles with a book balanced on their head or their feet. Think about that one. God's grace is like this, but it's so much more. It's all striking. God never fails and he never makes a mistake. Today, we're gonna talk about how God displayed his unfailing grace, even when the people he showed grace to may not have shown grace to others. So lean in, listen up, and grab your Bibles. Don't practice your head book balancing just yet. Wait a second. You're gonna want to read along in the story with us. Actually, let's go find Miss Allie right now.
Preparing for today's talk. Want to hear about it?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Awesome. Well, friends, if we haven't met yet, I'm Miss Allie, and I could not be more excited to talk with you today about Scripture and our big idea. Our big idea today is God's grace never fails. Now, can you tell me what grace means? Nobody? Okay. So grace means to fall short in something. And in response to that, you don't get what you ought to receive. Grace is an undeserved gift. Today, we are going to be reading from Genesis chapter 45. Let's find it together. So Genesis is the first book of the Bible, and we're actually looking for the big 45. You see it? Okay, before we start reading our Bibles, let me tell you a little bit of the backstory. A long time ago, there was a man named Joseph, and Joseph was one of 12 brothers. Joseph's brothers weren't always nice to him. And as Joseph and his brothers grew up, Joseph's brothers actually tried to get rid of him because they were jealous. Joseph became a slave in Egypt. But God was with him. And as Joseph trusted God, God put Joseph more and more in charge of Egypt. So much so that Joseph was even in charge of selling the food. Crazy. Now let me tell you why that's important. A famine came to the land, and that meant that Joseph's brothers had no food. But Joseph supplied for his brothers, even without his brothers knowing who he was. So before we continue in our story, let's actually use this whiteboard to help us talk about all the different feelings that everyone experienced. We know that Joseph's brothers were a bit jealous. And we know that Joseph himself was a little bit hurt. So much so that he didn't even tell his brothers who he was. So we're going to pick up in Genesis 45. And Joseph has already supplied for his brothers, but he hasn't told them who he is yet. But now it's finally time. Let's see what happens. So there was no one with Joseph when he made himself known to his brothers. And he wept so loudly that the Egyptians heard him, and Pharaoh's household even heard about it. Joseph said to his brothers, "I am Joseph. Is my father still living?" But his brothers were not able to answer him because they were terrified at his presence. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "Come close to me." When they had done so, he said, "I am your brother Joseph, the one you sold into Egypt. And now don't be distressed and don't be angry with yourselves for selling me here, because it was to save lives that God sent me ahead of you. For 2 years now, there has been a famine in the land, and for the next 5 years, there will be no plowing and reaping. But God sent me ahead of you to preserve for you a remnant on earth and to save your lives by a great deliverance. So then, it was not you who sent me here, but God." Wow, that's a lot. We know that when Joseph made himself known to his brothers were actually pretty afraid. And Joseph was feeling a lot of emotions himself. But who did Joseph give credit to for him being in Egypt? That's right, God. And in him trusting God, Joseph was actually able to show his brothers a heart of forgiveness and grace. Now, how did he do that? You see, Joseph trusted God. And in trusting God, Joseph began to understand that everything that was happening was a part of God's story and that God was in control of everything. This freed Joseph from the feelings he once felt of betrayal, of fear, of hurt, and allowed him to show a little glimpse of God's grace to his brothers. Now, years later, Joseph's father actually passed away. And when their dad died, Joseph's brothers were actually pretty scared that Joseph was no longer going to be nice to them. Let's see how Joseph responded to them in Genesis chapter 50. But Joseph said to them, "Don't be afraid. Am I in the place of God? You intended to harm me, but God intended it for good to accomplish what is being done now, the saving of many lives. So then don't be afraid. I will provide for you and your children." And he reassured them and spoke kindly to them. Joseph's brothers weren't perfect, and Joseph wrestled with a lot himself. But in trusting God, Joseph was freed from a lot of feelings he once felt and showed a lot of grace to his brothers. Years and years after Joseph and his brothers lived, God actually sent us the perfect gift of grace through Jesus. Jesus did nothing wrong himself, but Jesus died for all of our wrongs. Jesus actually took on all of our hurt and all of our grace and left us with an unfailing, overflowing grace. That is unfailing grace. Friends, we live in constantly changing times today. But just as God was unfailing towards Joseph and his brothers, God is unfailing towards us. Today, we can trust Jesus, knowing that we are a part of his story and that his story is filled with overflowing, unfailing grace. Today, we can remember that God's grace never fails. Let's pray together. Jesus, we thank you that you are the perfect picture of grace. We thank you for your word, and we thank you that you can live inside of us. We love you and we praise you. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Today's been so much fun. Let's worship God now, thanking him for his unfailing grace.
Friends, God's grace is amazing. We're about to sing a song called Lift Up Jesus. And you know why? Because he's worthy and because it's the best thing that we've got. Let's go. Come on.
There's just something about him. Fills my heart with joy. There's just something about his name. Only one that I worship. Only one I adore. Only one my heart will praise. There's just something about his name.
Here we go, let's go.
Jesus, lift up Jesus. Sing the fountain of life.
now, friends. Let's go.
Savior, He has freed us. Lift up Jesus, lift Him up. Jesus, lift up Jesus. See the day that overcomes. Savior, He has freed us. Lift up Jesus, lift.
Kids.
Today has been the best, but before we head out, let me ask you something. Have you ever made a mistake that you thought you could recover from? Have you ever done something you wish you didn't do? There was this one time my brother and I were playing in the backyard, and we decided we wanted to play baseball, you know, just brother things. So we grabbed our gloves and our bats, but there were no balls to be found. We knew there was one inside the house, so we just grabbed that one and went to the backyard. We were playing for a while, and when yours truly hit a home run, whatever, straight through our neighbor's window. To make matters worse, my neighbor dog, Rufus, suddenly had the best day of his life when a baseball came rolling across the floor. So we started chewing on it. Well, lo and behold, the ball from inside happened to be my dad's. It was a foul ball, and my dad caught it at a baseball game when he was a kid. I didn't think I would ever recover from that mistake. But my dad showed me grace and forgave me. In God, we're shown unfailing grace. Through Jesus, we can be forgiven from our wrongdoings. Just as God continued to show Joseph, his brothers, and his descendants grace, God's grace never fails for us. He showed us grace through his son, Jesus, who even died on the cross for all of our sins. Take some time to walk through these questions that are about to pop up on your screen to learn more about God's unfailing grace. And this week, when things don't go your way and you make a mistake, you can remember that God's grace is enough for you and me, and His grace never fails. See y'all soon.